Very different to last week. This time last week,
absolutely.
How was that?
That was amazing, Saudi, man. I mean, we got looked after really well. The atmosphere was a bit different in there because obviously there was no drinking. But the English lads, we tried to make it a cauldron. We made it great. You know, Sweet Carolina, someone playing. We was all dancing. I was next to Khabib. I was sat next to him at ringside. Him and his team were videoing me. I don't think they knew the song, but I made them understand this is a banger. You got to get with this song. Yeah. So they videoed me and put it on their thing. So I'm sure if anyone's following them, look out for it. Tag me in it if they see me in it as well. So I can bloody put it on my stuff, you know what I mean?
How did you think Killian did?
And he took some hell of a shots and he gave some shots which had to question Dillian in there, you know what I mean? But listen, when Dillian comes back in the new year, we will see the best Dillian White. There's been a lot of stress, a lot of problems on his back, and now the monkey has been removed. We're going to prepare better and he'll come in what he normally comes in when he's at his peak, probably around 17-10, somewhere around there, and he's at his fighting best, and we'll see a better and a more explosive Dillian White, and hopefully with a big knockout and a big name.
After everything he's gone through, Dean, was it just a feat to actually be in the ring?
Do you know what? It is as well, because you know that like, it's quite a lot of burden, a lot of stress. So we're training for training's sake, and then obviously we got the call about 3 weeks out to say obviously we're fighting. So you know you go in there, obviously you try to cut a bit of weight, it weren't really coming down in the end, you know, you go in there, you perform. He's happy, but obviously he still wasn't happy with the performance because we know that there's a better Dillian White normally. The performance is the performance. The win is the most important thing. We've got the win. We move forward in the new year. Actually, he's probably going to start training before the new year, but in the new year, he'll progress, he'll trim down, and we'll be prepared, and he'll probably be out end of February, maybe March, and it'll be a big name. It might be in Saudi again, might be headlining the O2. I'm not sure. I'm just speculating, but we'll be out again shortly, but you'll see a much better, much sharper, and a much slimmer Dillian White in full force because we're preparing for a world title fight shortly.
Can I just ask on the world title fight, Dean? Obviously, he's been given his mandatory back.
Yep.
But then you've got Usyk and Pulev that are seemingly in line next to Joshua. How can Usyk, to the layman that watch our videos, how can Usyk have one fight at heavyweight and be mandatory, and Dillian White seems to have been going on forever fighting these big names and doesn't seem to be anywhere near having a shot at the world title?
Do you know what it is? It's quite weird. Obviously, you've got a unified champion at cruiserweight unified. So when you come up the rankings, you become automatically right at the top. So he became top in the WBO because obviously he was their champion. So when you come up, they give you a position. So what's the position now? There's a potential. I know Chisora and Usyk were negotiating for obviously to fight. I know they've mandated the WBO Usyk to fight Joshua, but they mandated also Pulev to fight Joshua. I believe Joshua will vacate the WBO. Usyk will fight Chisora for the vacant belt. Joshua will fight Pulev. I think that's a more smarter move to do, which is an easier fight. And if you need to, you come back and fight Usyk later down the line. You know what I mean? That's just my thing. I don't know what's going to happen. But listen, this is the game of boxing. It's about chess and the moves they make. And this is what it is. Usyk's in pole position.
Two more. Is it still 2021? Do you think Killian believes that he'll get?
Do you know what? What people got to understand is they're saying it's the latest is February 2021. The latest. It could possibly happen in the summer of 2020 or September 2020. But we don't know. We got to see the outcome of Fury and Wilder, and we got to see if they're going to do a rematch and what happens. We hope to see whoever the best man wins. But I'm going to remember Fury is a UK guy and I wanted to win. If we can do that, and he says he's going to fight Dillian, he might fight him in September in the UK and bring the fight here, a mega unified fight. That'd be absolutely great.
Very, very last one. Have you got a message for the fans that have stuck by Dillian through thick and thin this year?
Listen, thank you guys from the bottom of my heart and the Team White and the White family. I know who they are and Dillian knows who they are because I've been in contact with a lot of fans on the DM and I've talked to so many people. So we know who you are and we congratulate you. You haters. Good chat.
Thank you, mate. Thank you very much.
Cheers.